Awesome. 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 If he wasn't on the throne, there'd be no worship. I was listening to Leo's testimony, just got him from Atlanta. I was talking to a young man the other day that's out of God. And I made, you have children. You get kids, it ain't about you. He said to me, he said, well, you know, I spend time with, I'm paraphrasing, spend time with my children, you know, and I said, he really didn't get it. The deal is, you can get them food. I said, but can you get to God for them? Welfare give kids food till they're 18. I said, can you get to God on behalf of your kids? See how we so screwed up in our mind, we think a bicycle and some skates and a hot dog is what dad is doing. I'm not boasting, but this is the reality. I've had to wrestle all of my kids out of the hand of the enemy. God help them if I'd have been a prayerless papa. Whenever there's a curse, there's a cause. Let's appreciate this lovely young lady. Come on now. Come on, we know who we worship. He who sits upon the throne. We're not beating that ass. We're not trying to find a God. We're not looking in a dictionary for his name. We're not trying to choose between Buddha and Allah and Jesus and Confucius. We ain't confused. We know who he is. And we know his name. Give her another appreciation. Come on, church. That's a little weak. That's a little weak. That's too weak. That's too weak. Come on, give the Lord praise. Give the Lord glory. Come on, bless him in the house. Open your mouth. Tell him thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Tell him how much you love him, how much you appreciate him. All right, God bless you significantly. Good. Thank you, Jesus. All right, let's open our Bibles to the book of Daniel.
Yes.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul.
Yes.
You got to watch it, that if you don't control your soul and tell your soul what to do,
yes, sir.
Your spirit has to tell your soul what to do, because your soul is not born again. Your soul will take you out there in left field. David always had to talk to his soul. One day he had a conversation between the spirit and the soul was acting real crazy. Wanted to be depressed. And David's spirit spoke to his soul, said, oh, thou soul, why art thou disquieted within me? Why are you acting cuckoo? You must be out of your mind. David told his soul, hope thou in God. God will put you in an environment where there is no breathing machine. Lay your hand on yourself and say, soul, you better praise him. See, that's where your emotions are. Now, you can crack up and freak out, but David talked to his soul. He said, soul, bless the Lord. He wasn't talking to his body. His spirit was speaking to his soul, his emotion. You see, your emotions will take you someplace you ain't prepared to go. You better take charge with a praise. You'll sit right up into this church and have a nervous breakdown. Sit up in here reading your driver's license, don't know your name. I want everybody to give him a crazy praise out your soul. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh soul, you better hope in God. Oh soul, why are you disquieted? Come on now, ho 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 ho. Your soul sitting there, it ain't got no sense. It only knows what your spirit tells it. Your soul's sitting there waiting on a pill, and the mailman ain't running. You better take a praise pill. Oh! I need somebody that refuses to have a breakdown and getting ready to have a breakthrough. It ain't but two breaks. You gonna break down or you gonna break through. Cause trouble is in everybody's way. And you got to make up your mind, I ain't gonna let trouble trouble me. I'm a trouble trouble. And the only way you can trouble trouble is you got to ignore trouble and give, my God. Sister Fowler told us there'd be no worship if there was no throne. Well, is there a throne? Well, then where's your worship? A father's major responsibility is to be able to get to God on behalf of his wife and his babies. The fire department will buy him some skates and a bicycle. You ride down enough streets in Montgomery, folk throwing away bicycles. That don't make you no daddy. Atta! Hey! Give him one more fat praise. I need a praising church. The Lord, I changed my mind. I believe I will praise him. The Lord, I changed my mind. I'm not going to have a breakdown. Oh, I'm going to have a breakthrough. Anybody know how to praise him? Let me give you a reality about walking with God. Folk, you know, you talking about I got faith. Your faith will get you in trouble. I said your faith, trust in God, will get you in trouble. Mm-hmm. But then when you get in trouble, you have to make a decision. It's trouble big my faith that got me here. You didn't get it, did you? See, if it's real faith, God will always let it be tested. God will back up and let your faith keep you. I say God will back up and go help a weak child who ain't got no faith. Come on, he said, I'll be back. But your faith gonna keep you because it's my faith.
Somebody praise him just for faith. See, see, you know it's God when you've been saying the last 3 weeks, I'm about to lose my mind. Don't take you that long to lose your mind. Devil, snap your mind just like that. If it's been 3 weeks and you ain't lost it yet, your faith is keeping your mind. Somebody ought to give him a praise up in this house. Here, you've been planning on dying since last year. You ain't dead yet. What does that mean? That means that there's an anointing over death on your life. You done brought four black dresses. You done wrote your obituary, planned the funeral, and wrote the date. Come on now. Come on now. And the date for the funeral has expired. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Somebody ought to give him a praise up in this house. Shama! Shama! Shikahom baraka! Give him a praise for your next miracle because you just got one. Come on. Come on, that's broke off you. I said, that's over. Come on. I said, that's over. Give him a praise for your next miracle. I said, give him a praise for your next miracle. Because that test is over. My wife told me we have some grandbabies that are two-year-old twins, Judah and Jace. Judah means praise. And so Jace, that's the boy, Judah's the girl. And so they were with my daughter Stacy, and Jace just crying, just whining and crying. His little sister looked at him. I guess she got to, she said, it's over. Tell somebody, it's over. You done ride long enough. Oh, it's over. It's over. Tell somebody, you got to use your faith for your neighbor. Touch your neighbor and tell him, it's over. It's over. What you know about Jesus? What you know about Jesus? Have you tried him? Have you tried him for yourself? He's all right. He's all right. He's all right. He's all right. Living, he loved me. Dying, he saved me. Buried, he carried my sins far away. Justified freely forever. One day. What's his name? Jesus. What's his name? Jesus. What's his name? What's his name? Who died? Who died? Who was buried? Who was buried? Who got up? He got up. Who got up? He got up. Come on, church. If he's worthy, you ought to clap your hands for him. Oh, yeah. You know what? If the devil can control your thinking, he can control your direction. If you so weak, you can't even talk about his goodness. If you can just think of his goodness. Come on. Come on. I want you to remember one excellent, most exquisite thing that God did for you. And I just want you to think about it and watch God set you free. And you know what? When I think of his goodness and all he's done for me, when I think of his goodness, how he died upon the tree, I could what? When I think of his goodness and what he's done for me, think of his goodness, how he died upon the tree, I could dance, 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 dance all night. Ha. Oh, it's a burden removing, yoke destroying anointing.
Yeah.
A burden removing, yoke destroying anointing. Somebody say a burden removing. Somebody say a burden.
A burden removing.
Break the yoke, Holy Ghost. Come on. Break that yoke, Holy Ghost. 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 Come on. Break that yoke, Holy Ghost. Point at your neighbor. And you ain't for sure, but just in case, point at your neighbor and say, break that yoke, Holy Ghost. Break that yoke, Holy Ghost.
Yes, God.
Go get your baby from it. Get your baby from it. Come on. Keep your hands clapping. Confuse the enemy's camp. Keep your hands clapping. Confuse the enemy's camp. Keep your hands clapping. Send an ambush into the enemy's camp.
Yes.
Hey, 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 let me just have your hand, baby. You trust your pastor? You trust me? I just want you to do everything I do, all right? When you hear me say something, I want you to say it. Now I'm 65 come July, and you just sweet 16 or so. So I know you can, I know your knees and your hips can at least keep over the mind. Are you ready? Whatever I say, I want you to say. Are you ready? Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Ah, give him some hallelujahs. Don't go yet. We ain't through. Give him some hallelujahs. La 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 la. I need a praising church. La 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 ba 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 ba. I need a praising church. La 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 masha. La ma kanda la ma. La kada ma. Just thank him. Open your mouth and thank him, baby. Now give the Lord a praise. I got you all here, Reverend. Daniel chapter 7. Tell the Lord thank you. Oh, bless his name. Thank God for every new job in the house. Thank God for every promotion. Thank God for every raise and pay. Thank God for every college scholarship. The reality is, listen to me, when it comes to salvation, we bring nothing to the table but sin. Well, I don't agree, Bishop. I brought a repentant heart. Well, God gave you that. Well, you say, I believe. That's right, but he gave you the faith. Salvation is an absolute total work of God. You don't do nothing but receive it. God don't say, I bring 90%, and you and your family got to come up with 10%. If your family lost, y'all can't bring up 0.5% at a 500 member family reunion. Salvation is absolute. So that means, I don't care how many sinner's prayers you pray, if God don't save you, I don't care how many times you get baptized in Jesus' name, if God doesn't save you, it's all God. That's why Sister Fella's song just blew me away. Come on now. We don't just sing about him. He is the song. Good God, I feel like preaching. Daniel chapter 7. Are you ready? I want to talk about Operation Wear Out. Operation Wear Out. Daniel was a prophet. He was the premier dream interpreter in Babylon. He, by the Spirit of God, by the gift of God in him, he could just unravel the most unique and mysterious dreams. He was a man that was an interpreter of dreams, and he could give a prophetic analysis of visions. His gift far exceeded the gifts of the magicians and the and those that were in the occult. But in chapter 7, God shows Daniel something that Daniel can't even understand. And the vision that Daniel sees in chapter 7 is a collaborative vision that illustrates the authenticity of the dream that Nebuchadnezzar had, with the image, head of gold, chest of silver, belly of brass, thighs made out of iron, feet made out of iron and clay. What God showed Nebuchadnezzar now, this is what we call the double mention theory. Out of the mouth of two or three witnesses, every word has to be established, come on, by a consistent witness. And so now, even though Daniel unfolded and revealed to Nebuchadnezzar what he dreamed about, when God shows it to him, he doesn't understand what he already saw. Because now God uses, in an illustrative sense, diversity, amen, to impact and to confirm what's getting ready to happen. Now, so in chapter 7, he dreams of four beasts. Now, these are not beasts like the Gila monster, Godzilla, Chucky, and some dragon. These beasts, God uses the terms beast because now God sets aside the nation of Israel, the apple of his eye,
He sets their rule aside for 490 prophetic weeks. And so now, what God now is doing, he says there will be a period of Gentilic rule. He uses the metal to illustrate the value of its government and its economy. Now, in the principle of double mention, he uses animals to illustrate the tenaciousness of a carnivorous appetite of its military strength and their desire to consume and to destroy. So now verse 15, when Daniel sees these four animals, these four beasts, the Bible said, the four winds of heaven strove upon the great sea, and four great beasts came up from the sea, different or diverse one from another. Are you still here with me? And so now, what God is seeing, what God is showing Daniel, is that there will be a period where Gentiles, well, God deals with three categories of persons in the scripture. He speaks to Jews, he speaks to Gentiles or nations, and he speaks to the church. The key to biblical interpretation is not to displace truth and superimpose truth that God has spoken to one segment upon another person or another group of persons. You have to know when God's talking to the church. Then you have to know when God is talking to the nations or Gentiles. You have to know when God is speaking to the Jew. Now you have to know when God is speaking to the Jew about the nations. You have to know when God is speaking to the church concerning the Jew. You have to know when God speaks to the church concerning its assignment in the nations. If you're not able to discriminate or exegete the text or textual environment where God speaks in a triune fashion to Jews or Gentiles or to the church, you'll get really confused. And so now God speaks to Daniel, and he shows Daniel, amen, something that will transpire during the 490 prophetic years. Daniel is a prophet. And there are two kinds of prophetic utterances. There's a prophet that foretells. That means that right now I'm speaking forth, so I'm prophesying. But then there's another anointing for the prophet. That's what we call foretelling, futuristic prognostication in the present time about a future event. You see, history is nothing but prophetic fulfillment as it pertains to the church, the nations, and the Jews. Now, God says, I'm going to build me a church. Now, he made that declaration at a place called Caesarea Philippi, a place that was licentious and lewd. They worshiped a pagan god by the name of Pan. Pan was half beast and half man. It was a very licentious environment. Matter of fact, it was so wicked, they called it hell. And so now when Peter receives a revelation as to who Jesus is, thou art the Christ, come on, the Son of the living God. You see, when you at the gate of hell, if you ain't got a revelation of who he is, the devil's going to wipe you out. Come on, somebody. You got to know in spite of what you see, you got to believe more in what he said than what you see right now. Because what you see is just temporal. But what he said is eternal. Come on, somebody. Let me tell you something. If God says, I love you with an everlasting love, if you make up your mind and go to hell, he's still going to love you in hell because it's everlasting. He never changes what he said. Are you listening to me? So if God says, in all things give me thanks, why don't you give him thanks right now? In the midst of all things. Not for all things, in the midst of stuff. Lay off. Come on now. Baby needs some shoes. Well, praise God, baby don't need no feet. Come on now. If you don't let depression get on you, you'll always find a reason to praise God. You can flip the script on the devil. If your light's off, you tell the devil, well, next month I ain't got no bill.
And you can keep praising the devil. Use that word. He'll back up. He said, I'm going next door now. You too awesome. Mother Boyd taught us you got to talk to him. Oh, like you talk to a natural man. Are you listening to me? And so now, ladies and gentlemen, in the text, when Daniel sees these beasts that are distinctly diverse from each other, their distinctness is an illustration of the difference of the nations that they symbolize. And so now, bear in mind now that Daniel speaks prophetically, and he looks down through the telescope of time, and he sees an invasion of eternity coming into time. And you see, and so why are we wrestling like we've never wrestled 15 and 20 years ago? But see, because now God has pushed us. Come on now. Time, come on, has unraveled itself, and now we stand in a moment where things that have never transpired before, spirits that you've never dealt with before, come on somebody, demons that you don't even recognize because you've never, I feel like a preacher here today, because you've never dealt with them before. Come on somebody, are you listening to me? And so now, the very economy of God, the very predisposed, predetermined, sovereign will of God has categorically forced us into this moment. And Daniel, he saw this day. And what he saw in this day brought him great confusion. And so now Daniel said, I see 2012. And I'm looking at a group of Nubian apostolics that embrace the monotheisticness of God. And I see the trauma and the struggle that they're going to have to deal with. He said, I was grieved in my spirit when I saw what the end time church was going to have to deal with. Well, you know, ladies and gentlemen, if Daniel saw it in a vision and it grieved him, we're walking in it. And it ought to grieve us. Y'all ain't going to let me preach right now. Daniel said, I was grieved. I, Daniel the prophet, I, the dream unraveler, I, the political, prophetic analyzer of events and circumstances. When I saw, when I unraveled what Nebuchadnezzar saw, it didn't grieve me. I just told him, give God the praise. But when I saw how ferocious and how carnivorous and how manipulative and how devious, and I saw the weight of the scheme, and I saw the magnanimity of the warfare, and I saw families being divided, I saw daughters slapping daddies and chomping on them. I saw witches trying to work stuff on preachers. I saw good folk. All of a sudden their love has waxed. I believe I preach up in here. Their love has waxed cold because iniquity is abounding. I saw ministers leaving the house of God and going sign up for Motown. Y'all ain't saying nothing up in here. You know, I like what Pastor Prophetess Jean Barbara told Marshall when he was a little boy playing on the pillar. And I almost want to say it scared the H-E-double-leg out of him. She said, boy, if you go in the world and pray and play music for the world, she said, your fingers gonna rot off. And it put the fear of God in him. Come on, Marshall went some places and did some things. But my God, he didn't sign up with Mary J. Blige. He didn't hook up with Cool in the Gang. Because see, Marshall like his fingers. Because his fingers got to make that barbecue. Y'all ain't saying nothing. If you believe that God's going to set somebody free today, jump up and give him a down payment on your deliverance. Help my Holy Ghost. Daniel said, I saw some stuff. He said, I was grieved. Period.
He said, in the midst of my body and the visions of my head, they trouble me. You know, folk that have a given to visions, sometimes we don't like to go into visions because what we see, sometimes we see trouble in marriages, trouble over folk, trouble that's coming to hard-headed people, trouble coming to folk who won't straighten up and fly right. And so Daniel said, not only did it trouble my spirit, it got into my flesh. He said, I came near unto one of them that stood by. And Daniel said, I'm a prophet, but I can't analyze this. I need some help from somebody that's deeper than I am. And so he said, I asked them concerning the truth of all this. And so now the prophetic analysis and the unraveling of the tapestry and the unfolding of the truth, now the watcher begins to explain it to Daniel. I'm trying to help us all here today. He says, now these great beasts, he said, make me know the interpretation. My God, I got to know this. I can't be living in these last and evil days stupid, crazy. Come on, somebody. I can't be living in these last and evil days thinking I get rid of Sister Lewis, I'm going to get something better. You better wake up and hit with your crazy self. Come on, you get something bitter but not better. Talk to me, somebody. And so when you're going through something, you need to ask God, what meaneth this? Talk to me, somebody. Have you been dealing with a lot of unusual warfare? Ask the Lord, what meaneth this? Have you been wrestling with spirits that you have never wrestled with before? Ask Chorepa, what? Give me the interpretation. You see now what happened to Leo and his wife and kids. I was in the Vietnam conflict. You see, but everybody in the war is not in the same theater of conflict. I was in the war, but I warred from marching by an airplane or putting folks, soldiers on the plane to put them over to Vietnam. We all served, but we weren't all shot at. And now here's the deal. Come on now. When you get into the drop zone where the enemy has control, that's when you really begin to fight an enemy you've never fought before. But if you don't understand why it's worse now than it was then, come on, somebody. Well, then you were just in basic training. Then you were just in AIT or tech school. You had your uniform on, but then, come on, somebody, you were just on R&R. But it ain't then, it's now. Now you're in the end of time, and you better fight because you can't switch. You don't have no options. You either deal with it or it's going to deal with you. You either take it out or it's going to help me, Holy Ghost. It's going to take you out. Either you totally trust God and what he said, or you're going to believe a lie and be damned. Where are my folk that's going to war with me? Daniel say, what I see, this stuff looks, them animals I see, my God, that looks so bad. I need an interpretation of this, because all of this hostility, my God, God, you got to open my understanding. And so, ladies and gentlemen, the Bible said that this guy said, these great beasts, therefore, and therefore kings. So now strategically, what Daniel sees is Gentilic rule of four distinctly different kingdoms. He says, now, then I would know the truth of the fourth, because I looked at that fourth one, and that rascal looked real bad. Come on, somebody. My kids, we had a goldfish bowl when we lived, I think it was in Woodley Park, I believe it was, and we had several little fish in the bow. But we had, you never had a long black one with big eyes. And then we had maybe one or two goals. But we had a little small black one. And that little one, boy, I mean, he was a hell raiser. I mean, he was just, I mean, he just bite the other fish. Come on, somebody. We wake up and he's swimming and the other fish dead. Daniel said, I looked at the fourth one. He says, not all those guys were awesome, but my attention was drawn to the beast that Macedonia is going to have to deal with in 2012. Now, he's different from the other ones. The other ones were awesome, but this guy, my God, I got my eyes on him. And so the Bible says, can I preach a little while here? The Bible says that I want to know the truth concerning the beast, which was diverse from all the others. Daniel said, now this one was exceedingly dreadful. Come on, church. Exceedingly dreadful. Well, boyfriend, I kill a 73-year-old man and kill 2 9-year-old babies. Exceedingly dreadful. Where a man will walk and eat somebody's flesh right on the ground and folk pass them by. Exceedingly dreadful. Where kids see their mama going crazy, they run out the house. She said, get your behind back in here. And she kills them all. Exceedingly dreadful. Where the devil will set up a great man like Dr. Dollar trying to correct his daughter and she gets an attitude and slaps him and jumps on him. Then he puts his hand come around her neck and they take a picture of the holy man like he's a common criminal. Exceedingly dreadful. Y'all don't want me to preach up in here. Hey man, it's so dreadful that the accuser of the brethren is accusing the brethren before God day and night. The devil wants you to look at somebody like they crazy, like they don't like you, like they don't love you no more. That's a demon. It's exceedingly dreadful. My God, if you believe that lie, you begin to become a prisoner of a lie. Talk to me, somebody. And Daniel said, I ain't never seen a beast like this one that Macedonia is going to have to deal with. 2012. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to crank that box up after a while there, minstrel. The Bible said... The Bible said now, he said his teeth were iron. His nails were made out of brass. And he stamped the residue with his feet. All he don't eat with his teeth. My God, he destroys with his nails. And all he don't eat and destroy, he said, I stomp him with my feet. Come on, folk losing their joy. Folk are losing their minds. Folk are giving up on God. Well, the Bible says that when this guy just roams and runs through the land, now you're not going to see no beast. It's a demon. It's a spirit that's stepping on folk, that's devouring folk. Come on now, why you think so many saints eating up other saints? They got a spirit on them. The devil has accused you before God. Come on up in here. I believe I preach here. And now that devil has permission to try your faith. My God, my question is, do you have a faith that can stand the trial? I heard the Holy Ghost say that. Come on now. You ain't going to get out of it. You got to go through. If the beast is trying to eat me, he's going to try to eat you. If he's trying to scratch me out, he's going to scratch you out. You can't pray your way out. You can't believe your way out. You just got to wait until your change comes. For I heard him say, they
that wait upon the Lord, they shall renew their strength. Come on, somebody. They gonna mount up with wings, and they gonna fly like an eagle. Come on up in here. Are you waiting on him? Are you waiting on him? Well, you know, I went to the restaurant, my wife and I, and we left a girl a lovely tip. You know why? She was a wonderful waiter. She was sweet. She told us her name. She said she's apostolic. She told us about a friend of ours in Benton Harbor, Michigan. Come on, somebody. She was waiting on us. She brought us everything we wanted. She brought us the to-go package. Then when we got the to-go package, we needed a doggy bag. And she wanted to put the food in the doggy bag. That girl waited on us, so I had to give her a big tip. Why are you waiting on him? Why don't you tip him with a praise? While you're waiting on him, why don't you tell him, I will trust and obey, for there's no other way to be happy in Jesus. Folk done found out. If you don't believe it, go across the state line. Ask them down there in Macon County. What does it profit a man to wait on Milton McGregor? Yeah, I'm gonna let me preach up in here. Ask the Democrats. What does it profit a man to wait on Obama? Lord. But I heard God say, if you wait on me, I'll renew your strength. If you wait on me, you'll get up and walk, and I'll strengthen you again. You start running, and I'll touch you again, and you'll take off and start flying. In spite of the beast, there's an anointing that can have you flying while other folk are jumping out of buildings and losing their minds while other folk are taking overdoses, PCP, mescaline, and mestadone. You'll have the joy of the Lord. I need somebody that know how to praise him with your hands, know how to open your mouth and give him some hallelujahs. Some of y'all looking, but y'all ain't praising. Come on, you got to wait on him. You want the tip? You got to give him some service. You want to tip? You got to give him what he wants. You want to tip? Don't bring him hot water. He told you cold water. Shake your neighbor's hands and say, neighbor, say the hour is dreadful and frightening. And so now, Operation Wear Out. Why and what in the world is going on? The Bible said this guy had 10 horns in his head. The Bible said, and when I looked at him, the same made war with the saints. Come on, somebody. The devil is making war with the saints. Y'all ain't letting me preach. Come on, somebody. I heard Paul say, through much, I like the adjective, through much. Or maybe that's an adverb. Help me out here, Doris. Through much tribulation shall you enter. How many want to go into another level, another dimension? Whenever God gives you entrance, you got to go through a door. He said, I set before you an open door. Come on up in here. Paul said, a great door. And an effectual door. Come on now. This door is going to effect change. It's going to straighten lesbians out. It's effectual. This door is going to bring gangbangers and cause them to be prophets. It's an effectual door. But since the door is so effectual, Paul said, there are many adversaries. Talk to me. Well, You know why the war is so great? I hear you, Lord. It's because what's on the other side of the door, and the adversary's at the door trying to devour you to keep you from getting what God has for you. If you've got your mind made up, come hell or high water, by the grace of God, I'm going through the door. Give him a praise by faith. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Give me a little on the monitors here, baby, if you can. Hallelujah. I'm waiting on somebody to go to war with me. Hallelujah. I need somebody with a machete called praise. We're going into the battlefield. This demon that we got to deal with is a different devil than what our daddy's dealt with. This demon that you got to confront as a first lady, different than what your mama had to deal with. Y'all ain't letting me preach up in here. Oh, yeah. The Bible said, he said the fourth beast, he's going to make war with the saints of the Most High. You see how bodacious it is, how dirty, how bodacious. He's going to make war with the saints of the Most High. Come on now. God gave me joy, and he's going to stand right in front of joy and try to take it. God gave me faith, and he's bold now. He's going to try to steal my faith. He used to be obtuse. He used to be oblique. He used to be in a camouflage. But now that buzzard is bold now. Come on up in here. He used to take your TV at night, but he'll come get your stuff right in the daytime. He used to he used to wink at your wife when you went to the restroom, but he'll wink right where you looking and dare you to say anything. Bold devil. Somebody praise him, because we got to go higher. Somebody say higher. Somebody shout higher. Somebody want to know what this means? Who wants an interpretation of this hour? Give him a praise for the interpretation. Yeah. And so the Bible said, and the 10 horns that shall arise. Oh yeah, it's got to arise just like God said. Some stuff must be. Some devils must come. Some trouble will be. We cannot change and alter prophecy. The Antichrist will come. Judgment must come. Men's heart will fail them for fear. The love of many will wax cold. Fathers will turn against sons. Sons against fathers. Mothers will fight daughters. Daughters will slap mothers. This will come to pass. You just got to make sure, Lord, by your grace, not me. Now the Bible said, and there will be out of the 10 horns, a little horn shall arise after them. He'll be distinct from all the others. He shall subdue the three kings. And now verse 25 is where we're preaching from. He shall speak great words against the Most High. Come on now. See now, he's so bold, he's not only accusing the brethren, he's not only telling you that we don't like you. He's telling God that we don't like him. He's speaking words against the Most High. Come on, somebody. Are you listening to me? He is so unbridled. He is so profusely and profoundly and essentially and intrinsically evil. Amen. That he doesn't fear God. He don't like God's church. He don't like the worship. He don't like the praise. He don't like fellowship between the saints. He don't like us greeting each other with a holy kiss. Talk to me, somebody. He don't like me having you to my house for dinner. He don't want you to have me to your house. Y'all ain't like this kind of preaching. He's speaking great words against the Most High. Now, not only does he speak the great swelling words against the Most High, but the Bible said, and he shall wear out the saints. So now, every military strategist, when they send you into a conflict theater, sometimes it's just to take a hill. Sometimes it's just to hold alive. But every operation has a name. Satan's operation is Operation Wear Out the Saints. Oh, that's his intent. That's his intent. You see, you don't praise like you used to because he done wore you out. You don't pray the way you used to pray because he done wore you out. I've been noticing you ain't been in the money line in a long time because he has worn your faith out. Y'all talk to me, somebody. Come on, you don't speak like you used to speak because the devil has worn your gift of hospitality out. Come on, somebody. You come late and you leave early. You love God, you think you do, but you can't stand the saints. Well, because you've been worn out and you're playing right into the prophetic hand of demons of end time. Talk to me, somebody. He got his fingernails in you, or he done bit you with his teeth, or he has stumped you with his feet. He done stumped your praise out. He's gouged out your seeing eye. Talk to me, somebody. I need to hear you over there, Marshall. You playing like a Baptist boy. You brought up in holy. Get with me, man. Hallelujah to the Lamb. Somebody give God a praise up in here. The Bible said, I got to have it. And the Bible said, he's trying to wear out the saints, wear you out of the usher board, trying to wear you out of the deacon board, trying to wear you out off the altar team, trying to wear you out, my God, off the praise team, trying to wear you out of trusting the people of God. And God said, it's got to happen. He said, I got to show you who I am. And I got to show you who you are. And I got to show you who that beast is. Had it not been the Lord who was on my side, shake somebody's hand and say, he would have wore me out. But the Lord was on my side. The Bible said, he's trying to wear out the saints of the Most High. And think, while the devil's wearing you out, he's thinking. Think the changed times and laws. You see, when you get worn out by the devil, the times change and the laws change. Well, when you weren't worn out, you didn't mind standing in church to 3 o'clock, but you wore out now. So the 3 hours preaching has been changed to 45 minutes. But you sit up in the hospital, come on now, and you waiting on a filthy hand doctor, a lesbian nurse, you don't know them, don't know the mama, they tell you to open your legs, you open up your legs like you on your honeymoon. Come on, somebody, I was too tired to come to church, but you drove to Jackson. And they say, we ain't the emergency room. You went to Baptist South. They say, you got to go east. And so you went east. Come on now. I tell you, lift your hands. And you roll out. You can't lift your hand. It's a demon. And you better resist him. You better wake up. This is the end time. The devil wants your marriage. The devil wants your kids. Let me ask you a question. If every parent that's 55 and 60, if all of us were taken out of here right now, nothing left but our kids, would your family be one generation of holiness? Or something you put in your kids that will carry your seed and your legacy? See, come on somebody. You've letting your kids wear you out. Well, he said he didn't want to come. So I just get tired of fighting with him. Come on, that's your problem. You fight with him, but you ain't fighting for him. That boy ain't your enemy. That's a demon trying to kill your seed. Come on now. And so now you so beat up and so wore out. When you do pray, all you can do is consume your prayer on your own little tired behind. But you've got to understand, they shall be given into his hand. God is saying, this must come to pass. Your faith must be tried. Because if you pass this test, I got a reward for you. If you don't let the devil blow you out of here, you've got an inheritance in this house. If he don't drive you out, I'm going to let him use you to drive him into me. Where you going to see what eyes have not seen, that ears have not heard, neither has it entered into the hearts of the sons of men, the things that God has prepared for those that love him. How many love him up in here today? You've lost your marriage, but you still love your God. Come on, somebody. The devil may have made you lose your job, but you still love your God. Trouble all around you, but you still love your God. You better know how awesome you are. The water's been in your boat for 6 months. Have you noticed that your boat didn't sink? That means that God is on the boat with you. The Bible said that these things must happen. He said, but the judgment shall sit, and they shall take away his dominion. What is God saying? When you go through the storm, go through the test, and you pass it, deal with that beast, deal with a sickness, or deal with poverty, or haters, and still got faith and love, hugging folk don't like you, praying for folk cursing you, God says when you go through, God says then judgment is going to come and sit, and God says, I'm going to give you the kingdom. I'm going to give you authority. My God, somebody better help me preach. God is not coming back for a weak crybaby church. He's not coming back for a church that's sucking on a titty. God is coming back for a church that believes the report. A church that says, though he slays me, I still trust him. I don't understand, but I believe the report. Anybody up in here? Almeida, get down here and dance. The devil stole your husband, a young man, but you still got to praise. Still got to praise. Still got to praise. Still got to praise. A young, strong, good-looking, black, working man. The devil stole it. But she still got to praise. I don't care what you're dealing with. I really don't want to know. But I do want to know this. Whatever it is, do you still have a praise? Anybody dealing with the beast? But you still got to praise. show the beast what he can't have. Because I know judgment is getting ready to sit. And come on now. And judgment is going, it's justice. God's going to be just. I waited on him. He got to give me my strength. I sowed seeds. I got to have my harvest. I covered my wife. She can't lose her mind. I covered my kids. I live right before them. My light's got to shine. The Bible. Shama. I don't care what it looks like. Trouble don't last always. Anything the devil sends, it's got an expiration date. And you know what? When meat begins to stink, that means it has expired. Anybody's situation starting to smell like never before, it means it's about to expire. Operation. Wear the saints out. Trying to wear you out. Some of y'all so wore out, you just found out the conference was going on this morning. Your mind so preoccupied with trouble and stress, you taking every anxious thought, you worrying about stuff you can't do nothing with. You worrying about paying a bill, you ain't got no money, can't get no blood out of a turnip, but you can get faith out of a believer. You don't need to believe when you already got it. Mabel, praise him for your deliverance. Baby, praise him for your liberty. Do you want to dance for being set free? Marie, praise him for snatching your husband out of the hand of the beast. Kim, bless him for putting your dance in your feet. Micah, get up here and dance. Let the devil know the beast can have anything, but he can't have my faith. He can't have my joy. I'm like Hammer. You can't touch this because you didn't give me this. You don't know what this is. I'm just about to get out of here. The Bible said, come on, they shall be given to the people of the saints of the Most High, whose kingdom is an everlasting kingdom. Baby, if you wait a little while longer, come on, what you get this time is everlasting prosperity. I don't care what they lose. You ain't losing nothing. It's everlasting. Come on, somebody. Your marriage. Oh, y'all don't believe this. How many of God can give you an everlasting marriage? That woman and John lost five of them. She was so wore out, she was now shacking. But she met her real husband. Shammah. Somebody get me Hebrews 12 and 1. My God, somebody give him a praise. Somebody give him a praise. Get me Hebrews 12 and 1. Hallelujah. You got it? Read. All right. Thank God I went to school. Wherefore, seeing we are surrounded with a great cloud of witnesses. Come on now. You're not the first somebody to go through something. There's a cloud of folk all around you that has gone through and went through, and God gave them a kingdom. He says, now these witnesses testify that I am who I said I am. Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego, take the stand. What happened? How did you qualify for the cloud? See, some of y'all want to be in the glory, the cloud, but you don't want to go through nothing. God ain't taking you up into the cloud of glory without a testimony. You remember when the Lord told John after seven traumatic experiences with every church? See, folks think, well, I go there, it's going to be better. Every church in Asia Minor had problems. When John went through all of them and didn't quit Jesus, no, the Lord told him, now come up hither. You ain't going up into the cloud until you learn how to love the crowd. See, I want to go away. I got to go away and be with Jesus. No. It's good to go be with Jesus. But when you get enough Jesus, now come deal with the people. I just got to shut in. Well, shutting in is all right, as long as it helps you shut up. But shutting in is not an escape. We all got to deal with this terrible end time beast. Are you listening to me, Pink? Seeing therefore we're what? Surrounded. Don't let nobody fool you. Ain't nobody living right. Just look all around you. All kind of folk that have been through. Read. Cloud of witnesses. Now here's the deal. Some of our trouble, it's not so much what the beast is doing. It's the weights we carry. Tell somebody, get rid of it. Well, you don't know what it is. I really don't. Whatever it was, get rid of the offense. You don't know what they said. I really don't. Erase the tape. I don't want to hear it. See, those are weights. And until you lay them aside, they will beset you. Courtney doesn't like her. So Courtney's swinging from the chandeliers. And she come in the church and she come down, get depressed. Come on now. See, offense is a weight. God says, lay them aside. You ain't the first one to lie on, not the last one. You're not the first one to be betrayed. You're not the first somebody that loved somebody and they didn't love you back. But don't let that weigh you down. Read. Easily. Come on. You see, the weight. Come on. See, if I carry 500 pounds on this side, it's going easily. And I'm trying to walk the railroad track. Which, when I fall off the track, which way I'm going? Because that weight is so heavy. The force of physics determines which way I fall. Read, daughter. Come on now. Come on. You know why a lot of us got real weary? We were running with a lot of weight. Athletes run with light shoes, real light material in their clothing. Yeah. They try to trim up, slim up. Read, let us run with what? Patience. See, here's the deal. A lot of us started off like a bat out of hell. Come on. And we thought holiness was a sprint. Holiness is a 26.2 long marathon. So you better pace yourself. You just better just get yourself a comfortable job. Come on. You just, you know, and Joe, when I run, just blow by me. Just blow by me real fast. It's all right. You know, I see at the end. So he young. He don't know how long this race is. Yeah. So I just, yeah. See, I'm running with patience. Running with patience. Mm-hmm. He gonna burn out. See, yeah. See, mm-hmm. He gonna burn out. See, he don't understand this. These are the last days. Turn on all our families, witchcraft. Devil, come on now. Ain't no prayer in the school. See, he in a hurry to get rich, so he done got 3 jobs and no Bible class. Mm-hmm. What's going to happen is he going to need his money to give the judge and the lawyer because his kids ain't covered with prayer. He going to get tired after a while. See, come on now. Come on. I'm going to get my second win. I ain't used the first one yet. See, you got to just get in the rhythm. Got to get in the rhythm of prayer. Thank you, Jesus. Got to be a lifestyle. Bokundalaba, bless your name. Some of y'all don't pray till you get to the gate. You got to pray without ceasing. Some of y'all can't praise if the organ ain't playing. You better get your own organ. Come on, you better use your come on, somebody. Some of y'all can't sing if you ain't got a praise leader. Well, if God been to you, good to you, you better lead your own behind in praise. Come on, somebody. Don't nobody know like you know what the Lord's done for you. I'm going to lead you in the praise, and I don't know what he delivered you from. See, you come on now. You notice? Come on, I ain't broke. I already broke a sweat yet. How long, oh Lord? 58 times in the scripture, it says, how long, oh Lord? You see, weeping may endure for a night. But joy comes in the morning. But the question is not whether joy is going to come. The real question is how long the night going to be. So you better get you a little pace. You better get you a steady gait. Come on, somebody. And the more I praise him, the stronger I get, the more I walk with him, the more I want to walk with him. Revelation chapter 6, saw souls under the altar, their heads had been cut off, the beast had destroyed them, and they were under the altar, and they asked the Lord, how long, oh Lord? It don't matter how long it is. Just don't let the devil wear you out. It may be a week. It may be 5 years. But you got to wait on him. God knows that everybody's trouble has an expiration date. How long, oh Lord? Well, I don't know how long. But one thing I do know. It won't be long as it has been. Yeah, because every day we get closer to the end. Every day we get closer to the expiring of my trouble. How long will I have to be single? I don't know how long, but not as long as it has been. How long before you fix my marriage? Well, the Bible said that they were beheaded for the word of God. Now one translation says they were beheaded by the word. When you get the word, it'll chop your head off and you don't think carnal no more. You let the word think for you. And so you keep on jogging. You don't get mad with the coach. You don't get hot-headed like some of these kids. I'm taking my ball and my bat going home. You better cut your head off. You don't get like some of these. You think you the star of the show. You ain't the star. If you were a star, the stars come out at night. It's dark. Where's your light? How long, oh Lord? I need somebody to go to war with me. Ask your neighbor. Say, neighbor, how long? How long has it been since you really praised him? How long has it been since you trusted God with your whole heart? How long has it been that you so trusted God? You told the Lord, whatever it takes to save my family, I trust you. If you got to break a leg, if you got to let them stay in jail, save them. Don't let them die. I'm laid off, but I'm still going to run. Don't have my husband no more, but I'm going to run with patience. I ain't gonna just pick up every Jim and Nick barbecue ball. I'm gonna be patient. Come on, somebody. I'm not getting out of one heartache and picking up another headache. I'm gonna run with patience. This next husband, I got to bring him before the bishop. I got to let the bishop check him out. This next husband, I got to take him through premarital. How long? This next one, I got to let him get in new members class before he get in my bed. How long, oh Lord? I ain't in no hurry. Because if it's to death do us part, you really won't marry. Y'all looking real crazy. Eight times they asked the same question we ask in the day. How long? God will not tell you how long, but he wants you to trust him. You upset with God because you gave God, you told God you need that money by Friday and didn't show up. Now you don't want to praise. You don't want to come to church. You don't like the saint. You know. God didn't break your heart. You broke your own heart. Where in the scripture does the Bible tell you that God will give you what you want by Friday? See, God don't have no Friday. He lives in eternity. Can I tell you the day God lives in? A day of rest. He wants you to come up there where he is into the rest of God. All that stuff that John saw in heaven, the praise, the worship, the angels, the saints, stuff was still happening down there in the churches. But John had entered into a place of rest. You know what got John there? He was boiled in a pot of oil. He was vanquished or banished, forbidden to preach. They put him on an island in the Aegean Sea, left him there with the geckos, the shrews, and the snakes. They put the preacher out there to die. And God showed him an eschatological revelation of the end time. Something about trouble. If your attitude is right, you'll get a clear revelation of who Jesus is. We met a young lady, and the young lady told my wife and I that a friend of hers, she's from out of town, she said, a friend of mine, she didn't know who we were. We were sitting there, and she was talking about us, didn't know who we were. She spoke very well of us, but didn't know who we were. And she said, my friend told me to call, called Bishop and Sister Lewis, and I couldn't get them. And I left word on the phone, and she told me, and I wouldn't call the house, you know. And she said, you know, she said, God didn't want me to get up with him. She said, God wanted to show me him. See, you'll never see Jesus as long as you're relying on other people's flesh.
Amen.
Yeah. How many know if you are a nipple-sucking baby at Beulah Baptist, you're going to be a nipple-sucking baby at First Baptist? Come on, run with me, child. Just get you a little jog. Don't worry about no shoes. Take them out. You, I don't want you taller than the preacher. So you got to run with patience. Now, the Bible said, now watch this. He said, look at all these witnesses around you. Then the word goes to say, now consider Jesus. You done looked at the witnesses. He says, now I want you, while you're running with patience now. Come on now. Because see, if you when you're running with patience and you don't know how long, you better be looking at the folk that went through the cloud, and you better be looking to Jesus. The Bible says he's the author. You see, this whole idea about faith, God authors that. You ain't know nothing about no faith. You should roll reefer. Matter of fact, it ain't your faith. It's the faith he gave you. So he said, come on now. So if his faith can pull you out of a hellhole, child. Now, come on. Can y'all come in right quick? Stay right there, daughter. Oh, yeah. Just real quick. Come on, Karen. Come real quick. Real quick. Get in the middle there. I need, watch this.
Put a circle around her.
Now, y'all all demons. This a reefer devil. This a whoremongering demon. This a boosting spirit. This a demon of suicide. Come on now. This a lonely spirit. Now, she is lost. She ain't never been saved. Now, if God can put faith in her heart in the midst of that stuff, that can, come on now. What's Sister Hatch's first name? Shaiwan. Come out of darkness. And ain't nothing darkness can do. Come on now. God's word, if you believe it, will translate you into a kingdom. God's word will translate you from depression to joy. God's word will translate you, come on now, from broke to prosperous. All you need is one word from the Lord. Can you believe that this is the word of the Lord? Just one word. God ain't got to say Shawan Hatcher, 364 Lily Lane, Montgomery, Alabama, 36115-02229. Social Security number 07. No. There may be a million Shawans, but when God says Shawan, he's talking to the Shawan he's talking to. And can't nobody else hear him but that Shawan. She can be in the valley of Shawans, but it's the specific one that he talks to, that he hears. How many hear him calling you to hold on, to trust him like never before? Don't let the devil wear you out. Don't let him steal your praise. Don't let him take your prayer life. Make up your mind, for God I'll live, for God I'll die. Make up your mind, if he slays me, I'm still going to trust him. There's a part of me that you can't get to, devil. See, See, your prayer life ain't for sale. Your praise ain't for sale. The confession of your faith, it ain't for sale. Your marriage, it ain't for sale. My children, they ain't for sale. Non-negotiable, irrevocable, eternally he God.
Yeah, yeah. Know what the Bible said? When judgment came, Karen, that means justice. And justice sat in the seat, Doris. Know what the Bible said? The Ancient of Days showed up. See, this demons ain't new to Jesus. Who you think showed it to Daniel? Jesus knew what we were going to have to deal with. And he gave us a grace. He put you in a house. He put you on an apostolic anointing. Come on, he gave you a holy word. He gave you a clean pastor, a holy first lady. See, the problem is, you think you're the only someone dealing with it. We all see his ugly teeth, and we all smell his bad breath, and we all looking at his iron claws. He's trying to stump us all. And God allows it to happen. And the scripture says, until the Ancient of Days appear. How many believe he's coming to the house? How many believe he's coming right in the midst of your trouble? I tell you, he's going to show up. And when he shows up, he wants to find faith. When he finally arrives, I don't know when, he wants to find a praise on your lips. He wants to find love in your heart, obedience in your spirit, commitment. Everybody stand on your feet and just give him praise, whatever you're dealing with, whatever you're going through. Just give him praise. Just give him praise. Give him praise. The Lamb is stronger than the beast. I said the Lamb is more awesome than the beast. Give the Lamb praise. Come on, sustain it. Don't stop. How long should I praise him? Until the crooked place becomes straight. How long should I praise him? Until the rough places become smooth. How long should I praise him? Until every mountain is brought down, every valley is exalted. How long should I praise him? Until my boys preach, my girls dance. How long should I praise him? Till my house is paid in full, my cars are paid off. How long should I praise him? I'll praise him till my mama get the Holy Ghost. I'll praise him till my sister get the Holy Ghost. I'll praise him till my husband sits next to me in the same house, praising the same God. How long, oh Lord? See, this is Operation Wear Out. Mother Shell had to leave. I think Doris may have fallen, I'm not sure. While she was sitting there, somebody wrecked her sister's car, tore it up, I believe. She had to go to the hospital, tore it up. She's still in the hospital. She had to leave, but she back. Come on. See, that devil trying to wear you out. See,
See, the deal is, you know, ain't nobody know your family got no strength but you and Doris. So if he can wear, if you see, you and Doris bear the burdens. So if he can wear you out, she ain't got a chance. If he wear you out, she won't even know how to spell Jesus. If he can wear you out, Jana may be crazy. See, here's the whole thing is, see, the devil, when you get ready to go through the door, that's when you meet the adversary. My wife just told me that we got a call. Who's the call from? Sister Lynn Walters got a call. Nicole's at home. She can't walk. But the deal is, that's an adversary at the door. Come on now. It's to wear her out. It's to wear her out. And see, I don't care how much money your husband make. Money can't do everything. Some stuff you can't get but through prayer and fasting. That's what I was telling that young man. He told me, I take care of my kids. I didn't let him walk away and get off being deceived, because you bring some bread. When the tornado hit Tuscaloosa, our folk took bread. We didn't even know the folk. I'm talking about getting to God now. I'm talking about the ability to deal with an end-time beast. Don't you understand that there are people in mental institutions that walk the floor speaking in tongues? The devil has taken their minds. How many in your right mind? Your money may not be right. I say, but you're in your right mind. Well, thank him that you're in your right mind. Tell him, thank you. I'm in my right mind. I like that. Let me tell you something. There are people in this town that have more money than all of us put together. And too sick to count it. If you ain't got but $3, thank God you can count it. Are y'all real slow? See, that's, come on now. Come on. Don't let the devil wear you out. I said, praise him. See, we need the revelation that it is God's responsibility to supply our needs. See, now you're getting ready to get out of church. You're getting ready to go to school and get two jobs, trying to pull out of something. You don't pull out of Babylon. You have to be delivered. Did you hear that? I said, you don't pull out of Babylon. Jesus. You got to be delivered. Can I help you with it? At the end of 70 years, Babylon had to let him go.
Amen.
There's a set time. The Bible says in that text that the beast would vex him and wear him out for a time and times and dividing of time. 3.5 years, he speaks prophetically there. Don't you understand that God knows what every one of us is going through? He knows all of our pain, all of our hurt. Come on. And God is allowing it. That's part of our perfection. If somebody breaks your heart and you don't get better, now the power of the kingdom can flow through you like never before. A broken-hearted person is very vulnerable. They got to be in the right environment. You just came in any kind of environment when your heart broken. Folk be whispering in your ear. Pss, 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 pss. When the ground, the fallow ground is broken up, it's fertile. It'll produce any seed that's put in it. How many believe that God's in control? When we lost David Hayden in Lake Martin, Pastor Joyce told me, I was worried about, we couldn't find his body down at the bottom of the lake. They searched and searched and searched and couldn't find him, Ella Davis. Pastor Joyce told me, she said, Bishop, she said, in the resurrection, she said, the Lord knows where to find him. How many know the Lord know exactly what's in your account, what's due on the 5th, the 19th, and the 21st? Have you noticed worry don't pay bills? But have you noticed worry eat out the lining of your stomach? So you might as well, you've done all you can do. You've prayed, you've fasted, you've given your tithe, your offering. So now you got to do what? Wait. Well, is he faithful? Is the Ancient of Days, did he lie to Ezekiel? Did he lie to Jeremiah? Did he lie to Jonah? Did he lie to Micah? Did he lie to Nahum? What about Zephaniah? What about Habakkuk? Did he lie to Micah? Well, who in the Bible did God lie to? Did he ever forsake anybody that he promised, I won't forsake you? That's your cloud of witnesses. Now, Jesus has authored our faith. That means he's the originator, and he's going to finish it if you don't let the devil wear you out. Your faith will not be finished until your test is completed. He ain't going to jump in the middle, bring you out because you're whining. He starts your faith. He leads you down into this prophetic time. He allows this vicious beast to come after us. He stands back and he watches what I've been putting in you for the last 12, 15 years. Come on now. Come on now. Then after a while, justice comes and sits in the seat of authority. And when justice looks at how you dealt with it, then it says, I give you an everlasting kingdom. I give you dominion. Come on now. That which tried to wear you out, now I give you power over it. That which tried to destroy you, come on now. Now I give you authority over it. You get it? Some real Christians in this hour. Folk gonna need to see some preachers that got grace on the zippers. I don't want no nasty preacher laying hands on me. Come on, church. I feel led to say this. I come to Melissa. I said, Melissa, I need you to pray. I just talked to Elaine. She told me don't tell nobody. But I just got to tell you. You know, because we tight. Now that ought to be a signal to Melissa. If I told Elaine I wasn't going to tell nobody, now I'm telling Melissa. You don't even need to tell me your middle name. Because, see, I got a spirit of betrayal. I just broke a truce. But you see, the devil knows who to send me to, because he know Melissa got a demon of receiving gossip. See, because if I go to him, he don't want to hear it.
But see, in the spirit world, there's an attraction there. You understand? It's all spiritual. You may be seated. I love this. Praise God. My God, my wife just gave me some good news, and I hope this is true. She said that Dr. Benahin and his wife getting back together. Isn't that powerful? Yeah. Oh! 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 How many know, even though the devil may break it, God can put it back together? I don't care what it looks like. I don't care how big it is. It's not too big for God. I hope God doubles Dr. Dollar's money and doubles his church. How many know we supposed to get double for our trouble? Oh, somebody get ready to get paid. I just heard that. My God, woo! I just got that out of my spirit. I said, how many know we supposed to get double for your trouble? The devil took all of Job's sons. The devil took all of Job's wealth. The devil took all of Job's daughters. The devil took Job's health. But after 6 months, God gave him double for his trouble. Anybody here that's been having trouble, I'm here to prophesy double for every pain, every heartache, every lie. Oh, that word for somebody. Somebody get ready to get paid. It got so bad for Job that he would take, they put ashes on his balls, and he would just take and just scrape the sores oozing out. He had three guys came to visit him, Eliphaz, Bildad, and Zophar, and they just sat around and looked at him. And you know what happened when they looked at him, Mona? They said, Job must have sinned. Come on, see, folk don't have all the information. You ain't got to do nothing wrong to go through. Matter of fact, if you live right, you will go through. Oh, you're getting ready to get paid, girl. When they finally spoke, they showed how ignorant they were. Know what Job called them? He called them horrible comforters. Physicians of no value. You got to be careful when you're sick. You'll have doctors that can't heal you. You feel worse after they leave before they get there. Talk to me, somebody. The Bible said when Job went through all of this, he didn't charge God foolishly with his mouth. He didn't understand everything. But he said, come on now, though the skin worms eat up my flesh, yet in my body I feel Reverend Threadgill from the Baptist Church on me now. Yet in my body I'm going to see God. He said, I'm going to wait. How many know it's worth waiting on? How many know if you lose 5, it's worth waiting on 10? How many know if you lose 100, it's worth waiting on a Bentley?
y'all ain't gonna let me preach. And then a young man shows up by the name of Elihu. He said, "But Job, what you need a go-between. Come on, somebody. You need somebody to reach up and get heaven. Bring heaven down to you and reach down to you and earth and bring y'all together." That's what Jesus did. When I'm weak, he reached up and got strength and replaced my weakness. When I'm broke, he went to the vault of heaven and wrote me a check. Y'all don't like me right now. Come on, somebody. Job waited on him. And you know what? At the end of 6 months, everybody that lied on Job, God rebuked him and said, "You're in trouble. And the only way you're going to get out, you got to go get prayer from Job." Didn't he say it? Didn't he say it? He said, "My servant Job, you better watch who you put your mouth on." You know what else God told him? He said, "Now give him a piece of money. Read the Bible." Am I in the book? Negroes will be coming and say, "Pray for me and take this little check." I'm going to look at it and say, "Bless him." If it got 2-0, I'm going to say, "In Jesus' name." Got 3-0, I'm going to say, "In Jesus' name." If it got 4-0, I'm going to say, "In Jesus' name, who is God?" That $1 million check, I'm going to say, "In nomine filii patri, amen." I'm going to go get deep in Latin then. God set the latter end of Job. When you study scripture, folk that walk right, their latter end is always better. Egypt, Israel, 420 years. The latter end. Everybody came out rich. Everybody came out healed. Everybody came out saved. Come on, baby. Come on. If there's a part of your marriage, a part of your health, a part of your finances ain't healed yet, hold on. He's going to heal everything. I said, God is dramatic. He wait the devil throw everything at you.
Yes, he will.
He said, "Satan, you got anything?" Satan, "I ain't got nothing." God said, look in the closet. That's something else. Because he already knows what he's going to do. You're going to hear a drum roll. Give me a drum roll. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the one that you've been waiting for the last 2,000 years, the Ancient of Days, Moses' rod, Noah's rainbow. Get ready. Stand by. Come on, somebody. The King of all kings, the Father creator, the Son redeemer, the Holy Ghost keeper, the author and the finisher of your faith. Sit at the edge of your seats. Watch him part the sea. Watch him do what other God can do. Put your fat hands together. Open up your big mouth and give a fat hallelujah for the cancer healer, the tumor curser, the blind eye opener, the marriage reconciler, the scholarship giver, the bridge over troubled water. Put your hands together, ladies and gentlemen, for he who is, who was, and is to come. Ladies and gentlemen, a greater than Daniel, a greater than an angel, God himself. Stand on your feet and watch him perform. But see, you won't see that if you let him wear you out. It's an operation. My pastor told us he would get so weary. He had a Dodge car. He said, sometimes I feel like getting in that Dodge and driving off to parts unknown. Come on. Well, David didn't have no Dodge. But David said, oh, if I had the wings of an eagle, I'd fly away. Come on now. Whether it's by Dodge or by eagle, you know. Everybody want to get away sometime. But I can't run from my test. I can't run from my purpose. Come on now. Karen went to law school. Now all of a sudden she don't want to take the bar exam. Well, that's what the schooling been all about. See if you can, come on. They've been preparing you for this test. What do you think all this word, all this prayer been? What do you think 90 days of prayer last year from June through September, 48, 12 and 1, 68. What do you think all this fasting? I don't know how many days we done fasted this year. Lose count. What do you think? There ain't no diet. I ain't no mean preacher. I'm not trying to keep you from the family reunion. I'm going to slap you. It ain't going to be hard, but it's the devil I'm slapping. It's the devil I'm slapping. It's the devil I'm slapping. She said, the devil about to hit you back. No, I'm just teasing you. You're my girl. I'm just teasing you. Pink, dance for your whole family before the Lord. That's for Lewis there. That's your seed, man. Come on. That's your seed. You dance for Pumpkin. This is no joke. Dance for your cousin Marvin right now. Dance for Jerome, your husband, right now, right now. Dance for your husband a good job. Yes. Now what he said, I'm finished. He said, when you look at the cloud of witnesses, he said, consider Jesus, who authored, and he's going to finish your faith. He said, now, who endured. See, you got to endure in this hour. Such contra. Contra means against. Diction, words were spoken against him, and he endured it. How could he do it? For the joy that was set before him. He kept his eyes on the finish. He despised the shame, but he endured the cross because he knew there was some joy coming if I can get through this. I promise you I'm finished if you'll praise him. Don't let him wear you out. I mean, this may seem impossible. As good as Maurice was, in the spirit, God could. I ain't prophesying. I'm telling you what he can do. God is able, as good as Maurice is, God could give you a husband twice as good as that one was. My God. I mean, we're dealing with God. A good-looking rich Negro up in here and all these young sisters in their 20s be looking at him. He said, excuse me, daughter, I came about a black woman last night and God told me and God told me worshiping on Selma Highway, and I went all over the other side of town to Old Selma, and the Holy Ghost said Highway 80. And I came up here, and you just switching.
Now, you ain't the one. I'm looking for a high. Now, you too high. I'm looking for a woman like she about 5'5". She got long hair. And she said when she praised him, she a little loud, dressed real good, and looked like she was driving a Jaguar. And God told me to come and pay all the bills off. Fool the devil, somebody shout, shy not. Now that's humorous. But if in principle, if God does give double for his trouble, when the devil took my wreath, that was trouble. We got to believe the motto. Amen. Thank God. He tried to wear us out, didn't he? How many stood? How many still got your joy? You still got to praise? Yeah. Ain't no figs on the tree, but I still got to praise. And no calves in the stall. Hello, Habakkuk. But I still got to praise. You know what Habakkuk said? He's given me hinds feet. That's the feet of a deer that can scale a mountain. You can walk against opposing when the force, the physics of darkness is against you, you can still scale the mountain. That's awesome. That's the strength of God. Yes. If you're not saved, how many got your joy back? How many know that it's got to be like this? I didn't hit you hard, did I? She said, I didn't hit her hard. See, I don't want y'all going getting on CNN. Preacher attacks congregant. You know, because some of y'all tape everything, put on Ustream. Then y'all put a little voice over. And be like Batman. Pow! You know, that's the age we in, church. It is so dark that when you tell a brother I love you, you have to put brother on it because he'll think you're talking about something else. Yeah. That's how the devil will twist your words. Amen. It's just, you have to tell him, I love you in the Holy Ghost, in the Lord. Yeah. Because the devil will take that and twist them words. Yeah. 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 That's how dark it is. But thank God that even gross darkness covers the glory is on us. Amen. If you're not saved, we want you to come now. Ooh, Jesus. If you're a backslider, we're real thin this morning. I want you to come now. We're praying for Michelle and Sister Evangelist Doris' sister. We're praying for Sister Lynn's daughter. Amen. The devil never stops. Neither can we. You don't ever get off walking by faith. If you're on the beach and pedal pushes and shower cloths, you got to stay plugged into the kingdom. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Well, everybody's saved. Thank you, altar counselor. Yes, ma'am. Sister McDade. Sister McDade's son-in-law asked for prayer for his sister, Rosalind. I think that's powerful. You know, when sinners will recognize that the church can pray. Father, right now, we pray for that young man's sister, Rosalind. You know everything about her. You know what she needs. Touch in every area where she needs to be touched by you, her spirit, her soul, her mind, even her body. Oh, God, help that young lady. Deliver her from evil. Touch her brother that requested prayer.
Lord, he's not far from the kingdom. If he's looking to you to do something for his sister, touch him too. All that pertains to him, I pray. Touch his wife, his child, in Jesus' name. I thank you for it. Amen. We want to get the Lord's offering right now before we go. Want the deacons to please come. Jesus. Sweet Jesus. Well, the conference starts Tuesday night. Thank God for Joyce. Amen.